Every now and then we hear about people who struggle against the odds to find hope in a seemingly hopeless situation. A Southland mother did just that. She found a way to help her son and others who suffer from a mysterious mental disorder.
Did you like the races yesterday?
The conversations are still one-sided, but Tobin Weber has come a long way since his mother first learned he was autistic.
They said he would be a vegetable and he couldn't even be toilet trained.
They were wrong, but she had to build her own school to prove it. Tobin World opened in 1977 with 6 students. Today, more than 300 autistic and emotionally disturbed children are educated here. They learn on state-of-the-art computers with personal attention from a staff of 150. For 2 years, Judy wore down California state legislators until they funded her program. Friends raised $50,000 for startup costs. As for the boy who inspired Tobin World, he now dresses himself, is toilet trained, and lives with an aide in his own apartment. Tobin proved the experts wrong and showed a soft-spoken housewife she could make a difference.
I had this baby that needed my help, and I didn't think I was capable of it, and I can't believe that it was me.
This is Catherine Steele reporting.
Dreams come true.
Dreams come true.
Dreams come true.
Oh, oh, oh yeah. Yeah.
Dreams come.
Your dreams
come. Your dreams come true.
I got involved with Tobin World many years ago as an employee of Los Angeles Unified School District. And my responsibility at the time was for the placement of students with exceptional needs. Needs that really extended beyond the capabilities of the public school setting. We've found over the years that this is one of the most successful non-public schools that we dealt with.
Oftentimes, the Department of Education will use us as examples because we do try to set the bar for the rest of the non-public schools.
We're a very behavioral type of program. We use a lot of positive reinforcement. Previously, they haven't received a lot of positive reinforcement in previous school settings, and I think that's one of our secrets to success.
Heart. You can't get anywhere with children unless they know you've got a heart.
I started the program for my autistic son, Tobin, who was severely autistic, and there was no program that would accept him.
Judy, because of her intensity and the bright people she's collected here at this school, put this thing together, and it's just wonderful.
There are many students that I know firsthand who have failed at other facilities that succeeded here.
Our school is really a place of last resort. We take the most difficult students in Greater Los Angeles and rarely turn anybody down because of their behaviors. As a parent, I couldn't find anybody that would take my difficult son. So I decided I can't have parents go through that. So we take everybody.
My favorite part about working here is when the parents come up to me and tell me that they're so happy that their children have progressed, or even that they've been able to tie their shoes for the first time or wash their hands by themselves. Even the tiniest little bit of progress for some of our students is huge.
About 4 years ago, Tobin World opened a county mental health clinic. There were very few behavioral clinics. I had parents calling me over and over again saying, I know my son's doing well in class, but when he comes home, I don't know what to do with him. So now we counsel them, and it has helped the children so much.
Tobin World is based on a reward system style program.
Our staff wear aprons throughout the day, and they hand out the tokens when the students are staying in their seat, doing what they're supposed to do, you know, working quietly.
Good job, Lamala. There are two tokens for you.
This is what educators know works. It's just that not everyone has all the capabilities to conduct such a program.
Our reward store, it's kind of set up like a carnival in which our kids get to visit that particular activity one day a week, seeming that they've shown positive behaviors.
And the students will earn a contract to be able to purchase things in this reward store. Depending on the number of points that they have, they can earn either the merry-go-round or the Xboxes or the popcorn or whatever.
Our teen lounge is based in our high school. Each student gets an opportunity to visit the teen lounge one time a week.
We only had a little room available, so I mirrored it and tried to make it as big looking as possible, and it's appropriate for teens now, and they love that. Well, the contract store is my invention. We used to show the students photographs of items that they could earn, and I thought, oh, who cares about a picture? Why not show them the real thing, let them go visit it, and maybe we'll get control of their behavior by them seeing the object, handling it, and earning it.
On Fridays, we have our activity day where the students get to choose an activity they want to participate in if they've had good behavior all week. We have barbecues every other Friday where the students come out and we have like a picnic type atmosphere.
There's no comparison to what you see at Tobin World and what you see at other schools. As you walk in the door, you see freshly painted walls, clean floors, furniture that's not broken, blackboards that are clean and ready for use. You see books that aren't torn or marked.
My goal is to train them so that after they graduate, they can all do something and not have society have to put them on the welfare funds. My dream is to have Dream Street, and Baskin-Robbins was the very first. I wanted it as a reward for the students, for them to be able to spend their tokens, but mostly I wanted it so students could be trained to work in other stores. Those that could learn to use the cash register, those some could only learn to sweep the floor. We're very proud of our transportation department. We have been told by the California Highway Patrol that we are the best, and they use us as an example.
Yay, Tobin World!
We cover 300,000 miles a year. We now have 22 buses.
The behavior program carries through to the Christmas show. The kids know what the expectations are.
I see trees of green. Wonderful world.
parents, they start crying when they see the kids up there doing their songs. The kids just wouldn't get the opportunity otherwise to do that kind of thing.
I'm Matthew's mom, and we love Tobin World, and the show was great.
They care. They have a big heart. They offer our kids so, so much.
I don't know what I would do without the school. I love it.
Out of all of the special ed, thank God for Tobin World, because I find them to be the best.
My son learned how to read and write here. No other school had taught him. I'm really, really grateful to Tobin World.
They said that when my baby came into the world that he would be institutionalized for the rest of his life, unable to learn. Tobin World proved that not to be true.
Next to Disneyland, Tobin World is the happiest place on earth.
I need a sign to let me know you're here. All of these lines are being crossed over the atmosphere.
I'd like to thank Judy for just having the determination, and I look at her and I just, you know, just admire her for everything she's done.
I don't know what we would have done without a place like this.